I start my class, the previous class recapitulation, what is history and why should we study history. I have given you a beautiful example that the history of cricket in India, how India 1932 won the World Cup, and since we know we are a cricketing nation and we can be good at something in the world on the top, and the medals we have won in cricket, that history of cricket motivates you to play cricket. You think you can be Virat Kohli or Rahul Dravid. This is how the history gives us an identity, history motivates us, and that's why you play cricket more than any other game. How you know you can play cricket well? From the history of the Indian cricket team. Okay. So, I discussed all that. Now, I am coming to my new topic today, that is early man. Evolution is a process in which an organism adjusts to the available food and the climate and other conditions, and some sort of adaptation. So, adaptation have taken place from the very beginning. Let us see what happened initially. The eagle eyesight is 10,000 times better than ours. Eagle flying 600 feet high can see a rat crawling in the grass. But can you see? No. Dogs can smell up to 2 kilometers. Animals can smell 2 kilometers, 3 kilometers, because the smell sense is very keen, very sharp. We can't. I standing here, I can't smell and say who is standing outside the principal's office. But what happened to the human being? In those cases, the hearing skill, the smelling skill developed, but in case of humans, the brain developed. The brain, there was a massive growth in the brain. The brain become bigger and bigger, that made man wise. Earlier, we were like monkeys, you have been seen in the photograph there. As brain developed, his activities developed, his thinking skill developed, his analyzing skill developed. He was no longer animal but man. His tail disappeared because his brain developed, and then he learned to walk on two legs. When he started walking on two legs, then the tail was of no use because he was no longer jumping from tree to tree. Due to evolution, his tail vanished. Then his two hands were functional. I can pick up the duster like this. Can a tiger pick up it? Pick up a duster? No. Tiger cannot pick up. Dog can pick up? No. Elephant can pick up? No. So these changes took place in man, and thus came the existence of stone man or early man. Now, why he is called stone man? Is he made of stone? No. Then why is he called stone man? The reason is, all his tools were stones. If I entered your kitchen, there is no stone instruments. The stainless steel and other knife and everything. But the stone man had only instruments of stone, early stone age. His instruments were stone. Early man was a nomad. Nomad means he moved from one place to another. He lived in caves. The man is basically a fruit eating animal. Now you ask me why I say man is a fruit eating animal, because we got a long intestine. All those which are carnivorous animals have short intestine. We have a long intestine that shows we are fruit eating animals basically, and earlier we are created like that, we came from monkeys, not from tigers. Do you think you come from tiger? No. But you believe you came from monkey. Okay. So, now his two hands were free. Where was I? This is an old stone man. Now, stone man was a nomad, a hunter and a food gatherer. 2 points to be noted. Hunter and a food gatherer. Again, as a hunter, his early stone man's instruments were blunt stones, not sharp stones. So, I think he was not a good hunter. Early stone man, Paleolithic age. Because he didn't have the gun or arrow and all that. So, probably he was a food gatherer. Why he was a nomad? Let us analyze this. Why he moved from one place to another? First reason, the animals moved from one place to another. Animals were the source of food. They were migratory in nature. So, man also moved behind the, probably behind the animals, so that the food source is intact. Second reason, if they live in one place, the source availability of food will finish because of consumption. Therefore, he has to find a new location where food and water is available. Therefore, might be that reason he moved. Maybe he had some friends, he moved from one place to another. Whatever be it is, he was a nomad. He moved from one place and he was a food gatherer. He early man is used to eat raw flesh, fruits, roots and vegetables. Have you seen anyone eating raw flesh? No. Early man ate raw flesh, fruits and vegetables. Then early man made two important discoveries. The first one was he invented tools. Second and the most important one was fire. While grinding two pieces of logs, timber, he found from sparkling, something sparkling, and he discovered fire. You put some dry leaves and rub to say this is a wood piece, this is a wood piece. You keep rubbing it like this. After some time, due to friction, heat will be generated and this will burn. Put some combustible material like dry leaf and you can get a fire. This is how stone man discovered fire. Now, this was a great invention for him. The fire helped him to cook food. He no longer had to eat the raw meat. He could cook his food. The fire, he lived in caves, so the fire burning at the front of the cave gave warmth. It helped him to keep himself warm. Insects and mosquitoes were driven away by the smoke, so that way it benefited. Then later on, the same fire was used to make earthen pots. So, fire was very useful to man. Man had used pieces of large stones as tools and weapons. He now started making stone tools. He shaped stones for different needs, for cutting trees, killing, skinning, chopping meat, etc. Hammers, axes, scrapers, coppers, belonging to this age have been found in many places in India. Man made two types of tools, core tools for making other tools and flake tools made from smaller pieces of stone. Paleolithic sites have been discovered in many parts, in Soin Valley in Pakistan, Balan Valley in Uttar Pradesh and in Bhopal. The first animal to be domesticated, can you tell me what it was? First animal to be domesticated. The first animal to be domesticated was dog. And this dog came from grey wolf. And it happened in the Paleolithic age. They brought some newborn grey wolf puppies and kept with them. The wolves have a great fear for man, but when these wolf puppies grew along with human being, there was no fear. They became man's companion, the first animal to be domesticated in Paleolithic age by the early stone man was dog, which came from grey wolves. The dog protected his cave. The dog protected him from wild animals. The dog protected him from reptiles. The dog could sense any danger and alert him. Dog helped in hunting. So this was the first animal to be domesticated in the Paleolithic age. Now comes Mesolithic age. In Mesolithic age, that is the second stone age, we call it middle stone age. In this age, tools become finer. They were no longer using a big stone as a knife. They learned to make a small knife out of stone. These are called microliths. Now they had better tools. Man now started making smaller, sharper and more efficient tools. Because of their size, these tools were called microliths. Micro means small. Lith means stone. Microliths. The new tools included bone tools, bores, scrapers, arrowheads, axes, were given wooden handles, were made them easier to use. The bow, the arrow helped them in hunting. Bow and arrow came in Mesolithic age as middle stone age. Then comes, now the fire has been discovered, the wheel has been discovered. Wheel helped man to carry goods, heavy goods from one place to another. Fire has been discovered, wheel has been discovered, dog has been domesticated. So that comes in Mesolithic age. Then comes Neolithic age. Neolithic age means new stone age. In new stone age, a big change came into early man's life. What was this change? He learned agriculture. Agriculture developed. He discovered seeds. Now, he learned that if he plants some seeds, then it will give fruits. So he started agriculture. For doing agriculture, they have to live in a community. The man, instead of being food gatherers, had to settle down near sources of water. And the fertile soil beside the rivers were used for agriculture. In agriculture, you can see the farmer works 3 or 4 months and then he takes rest. Am I right? He sows the seed. He works hard, but it's not all through the year. Stone man also, he sowed the seeds. He worked hard for a few months. Now he had enough time left. He could plant the crops, he could harvest it and keep it, store it and use it. Now he had a lot of free time. Gradually they started settling on banks of river and lakes where water was available. For this they needed a shelter. The man, now see, they want to live in one place, no more caves. Now you can see the concept of village coming in. So they want to stay in one place. To stay as a community, you need to have a discipline. You need to have law. You need to develop some sort of language to communicate. Earlier, the new stone man did not have linguistic skills. He didn't, language was not developed. Now in this stage, that is Neolithic age, we can see language, dialect we could rather say, developing, communication, living together and taking part in agriculture. Man living together also gives man safety. Gradually they started settling on banks of rivers and lakes. For this they needed shelter. Man constructed dwellings out of many things which were easily available, mud and leaves. People began to live in groups.